Okay, let's start. Welcome, everybody, in this session. This is a hands-on lab. So the idea is all of those who will want to test and to work with us on this subject will be able to do them. For that, the prerequisite will be to have a MacBook and macOS with Xcode. A little poll about you. Who doesn't speak French? Okay, those we do it in English.
No problem.
Who is already doing some iOS development? Few of you. Who is already using Jenkins? A large part of you. Those, I imagine that both doing Jenkins and iOS development, one people. Fine, two people. Okay, let's introduce myself. I'm Arnaud Héritier. I'm committer on Jenkins for several years now, especially on the Maven integration. I am also a Maven committer, so I worked a little bit on this part with Olivier Lamy and some other like Stefan. Here, and I worked sometimes on few plugins like the Xcode plugin and the Appaloosa plugins we will show you in action today. And my daily job is working for an ISV, Exo platform, where we are doing various products and some of them are mobile applications. That's why I have a few experience in this domain.
Hello, I'm Mathieu Husser. I'm iOS developer since the first App Store release in 2008. I also develop for other mobile platforms like Android, Bada, BlackBerry, and Windows Phone 7. Today, I work for Octo Technology, and I admit that I can develop without a full software factory today.
Those, we tried to have some slides easy to read, as you may on your side try to follow exercises and what we say. Those, what you will need, it is to do what we propose. It is to have a Mac with Xcode. You will have a little label with action when we will ask you to do something. And we will explain in this presentation many workarounds or many tips we had to apply to have this continuous integration using Jenkins and iOS. And those that will be marked with a workaround flag. And you will find, you have a URL at the bottom of the slides. We try to have it shorter as possible, where you can find slides to follow the exercises and to find to be able to copy paste a few data when you will need it. Need them. Those, for today, we did three parts. We will start with just some concepts about iOS development and continuous integration using Jenkins. How we are going to continuous integration and continuous deployment. We will show you those. We will do an overview of the environment step by step to set up the server, what we are using, how we set up the application to be sure that everybody can see it, even if you don't have the environment here today to do it. And then we will have the hands-on part where you can practice yourself and play with a sample application and the environment we prepared. Those about concepts.
First, a little remember about Apple certificate and provisioning profile. Apple provides three kinds of application. Application for the App Store. Application for the App Store, you can build an application for the App Store and it's built for life. But there is two other ways to build an application: for your enterprise, in-house provisioning, or for a developer, ad hoc provisioning. these applications are available, are valid 1 year. And the only difference between the two concepts is with a normal ad hoc provisioning profile, you can just distribute to 200 devices. Today, we will use an ad hoc provisioning profile to deploy an app on your phone, but in your work, you can deploy for all people in your company. With certificate, there is some little tricks. On a Mac, you can't have two certificates with the same name. Every year, when your certificate expires, you have a new certificate with the same name. So, for the good practice is to create a specific keychain with only one certificate on your Mac for Jenkins. There is a problem with these tips. The command to choose a keychain used by the Jenkins plugin is not thread safe. It's a security set default, it's not thread safe. So to use this kind of concept, you have to have just one executor per node. Why we need automatic distribution? First, like in every project, it's a good practice to have feedback of the user to the developer. It can improve your time to market. You can spend time to develop instead of distribute. But there is another use case. Every year, you have to rebuild your app for ad hoc and in-house profile, and with Jenkins, you can be sure that that this build is like the last year.
Those, we just took concepts that are already existing and are used in a classical development environment on many technology stacks we can have. So the continuous integration is just to have our source in a version control system to have something being Jenkins is a better choice, but it can be something else. But in our case, it is Jenkins that will take these sources and build the artifacts, the delivery regularly. It will also execute some tests. For example, there are various type of tests, from unit test, UI test, depending of the technology you are using. And you can have also some reports about the quality of your application. It could be about the source code itself, about some programming error and things like that. So this is a continuous integration concept. And nowadays, often people are going further and are trying to deploy the application in an environment being pre-production or QA to validate it. And thus in our case for mobile stuff, for mobile developments, we have the same process using also Jenkins to build an application that can be deployed on a store. We'll see that we will use a private store called Appaloosa. And this store will be able to distribute on various devices the application. Thus, you may automate the review of the application, the test of compatibility of this application, and so on. And you have some various additional tasks, like creating documentation if you want to publish some APIs for other developers, other applications, for example.
What's Appaloosa? Appaloosa, it's a private store. With Appaloosa, you can deploy your app on your company Appaloosa is free to use, but there is a premium feature, and we will use this premium feature today. To use Appaloosa today and to test the demo application we provide the program of the conference today, I need your UDID. So if you can, with your phone, just download a UDID app like UDID Sender in the App Store, and send me an email with your UDID. I'll be able to deploy app on your phone today. My email is mha@okto.com.
For all of you who want to participate and try to set up in those less 1 hour a CI environment and to have an integration loop and deployment loop, feel free to send an email with your UDID to Mathieu. Let's talk about the setup. I will show you in live. It is more interesting than some slides. You have slides that are available also with some screen capture. What we have, those in our case, to do mobile developments with Jenkins and iOS, the first step into is to install a few plugins. What do we need? We are using the Appaloosa plugin that we will use to deploy this application, our binaries on the private store. We have to say that this plugin and the Appaloosa store can be used on others mobile devices like Android and Windows Phone. This is why myself I used it in my company, because we had developments in Android and iOS. Those, instead of having various solutions for each population of application, we chose Appaloosa, which allowed us to have only one system to publish all our mobile stuff. We are using the Selang scan build plugin. This is a plugin to validate development and coding errors in iOS development, especially for memory errors, and to try to avoid leaks, memory leaks. For those who are doing some Java developments, it may be like a check style or like a PMD. This is this sort of tool that is doing some analyze of the code source to give a report on various aspects. We will use Git. We hosted our code on GitHub. We use, but it is by default, the SSH slave. It is to show how to use a remote agent. And the Xcode plugin, the Xcode integration plugin. Those, we just install these plugins, Appaloosa, Selang, Xcode, and Git in this case. And those about the configuration, we have really few things to do. In the configuration part of Jenkins, we have the Selang plugin that requires to be installed on the computer where you will build your application. This is an archive to unzip and to set on your computer. We will see that it can be set up the path on the level of node when you are in an architecture with a client server for Jenkins. So you define one installation of Selang plugin, and for the Xcode plugin, the major part of you won't never have to change parameters. These are default parameters we have in a macOS environment for build tools. That's all what we are doing in terms of setup Jenkins plugins. We install and we configure. The question is often, is that we may have is we don't have our server on a macOS because we have already a Jenkins server on another environment, maybe Linux or Windows. And thus, in that case, what we will do is that we will need, it is required by the platform, the iOS platform, we will need a computer with macOS. Ourself in my company, we have just a Mac Mini, which is doing just this. It is used to build application. And in Jenkins, we use this computer using a node dedicated for this platform. So I reproduced it, this setup on my computer. I just have to open SSH access to my computer, and I create a node using an SSH key. I just give it a path, the number of executors I want. Those, as said Mathieu, as there are some binaries on macOS that doesn't allow to have a parallel run because they are on thread self, we consider to only execute on one computer, one build at a time, if you want to avoid issues. But these are a problem due to Xcode. And those few parameters you may know in other use cases. We just have one thing, it is to have a label dedicated for this job, and we can use it in our jobs to set up the environment. Let's continue with the slides, if they want to come back. Go. They are here. Those plugins configuration, those the architecture with nodes or not, depending on what you need. Creation of a node. And the affectation, how you are using a node is just in a job you are creating, you will just say hey to restrict where you want to have this execution done. In our case, it is on the macOS node. Thus, it was the easy part. The easy part is Jenkins. But sadly, Xcode, it is less easy. And there are various limitations or bugs in Xcode itself that for now aren't yet fixed in current versions. I let you
first one, the macOS system doesn't allow unit tests on iOS platform. It's just not implemented. So you have to edit a bash script and replace some line with suppress a warning and replace some export variable to do unit test. Next, the test target on iOS doesn't work, so you have to create a scheme, a particular scheme, with your test target runnable to run tests on Jenkins jobs. So on your Jenkins configuration, you have to commit your scheme on Git with a scheme shared scheme, use your scheme to build the app for the test, for unit test, but the scheme doesn't work for standard build. So you have to use the scheme for unit test and a target for standard build. For unit test, you have to use iPhone simulator to SDK. You have to configure the build in debug mode and add a variable test after build to yes. So with this workaround, you can read that at home. We have done this in this Mac. You can use Zen Test Kit. So for example, it's a standard test framework. You have just to write your test, and you can also use OTC-mock to use mock in your test. When you have your build, you have just to configure a C-lang scan build target, and you can have a report to memory leak and to other programming stuff. Next step, we will use Appaloosa integration in our software factory. So when we have the Appaloosa Jenkins plugin, we just have to build an IPA, so a compiled file for iOS, and add an upload step to Appaloosa. When you have an Appaloosa account, you have an Appaloosa token. You set the token, and directly the job upload your file to Appaloosa, and your phone is notified. For publishing in the App Store, there isn't any automatic way. Apple doesn't provide API, so they don't provide public API, and you need manual action to do that. There is two problems with that. There is manual action, but manual action on a Mac. You only a Mac can post application, and the Mac can be you can't use proxy because of this protocol isn't proxyfiable. Last step, if you have Apple Doc in your project, you can generate some doc in your jobs. For that, you just have to install Apple Doc script. It's on GitHub, and it's a command line. If you will generate your doc in Jenkins, this command line, it's okay. But you can also add that in a target in your project in Xcode to perform automatic doc generation on your Mac, on your development Mac.
Okay, those I will show you just what it gives when it is in what it is already done. Those I already created two jobs. The first one is the continuous integration or build. I think I didn't configure it to trigger on Git changes. Yes, it's just a manual build for now. So what we said, we have the C-lang plugin that is used, configured, and the Xcode target. So we are using the schema because of the need to execute tests. We are using the SDK iPhone simulator, and I patched my installation of Xcode to allow the execution of tests on this type of device. Configuration debug and the extra argument to ask to execute tests after the build. The cleanup and the generation of test reports is activated. And those in my build, I just have two post-build actions, which are the generation of C-lang scan build results and the GUnit test results, because the Xcode plugin will generate from Xcode outputs a file compatible with GUnit file formats, and those we can integrate then. This is what we can see. I don't know what it can give. Yes, with this resolution, we have the report. It was Mathieu who wrote the application, so there is no problem in C-lang. It is a very good guy, a good developer on iOS. And test results, those we have few test results, and they are all working fine. If I build, I'm not sure I will wait for the end. It may take 1 minute, and There is, it is really verbose to execute Xcode. But we have all the execution of the build automated in Jenkins. That's good. Everything was updated. If I come back, I have my build number 30. This is for the integration build. In my company, we are using that every day to develop our iOS applications to ensure that we can easily build them and we can have automated tests on this application. So this is the first part, which is interesting, and we are sure that we reduce all problems due to environment configurations that are doing that the application is working on the developer environment and not on the device or on the another developer environment. So this is for the continuous integration, continuous build, and we have the ability to have a continuous deployment or a manual deployment. In my company, it is we are using especially the promotion plugin to do the deployment manually when we our product manager decide to validate it for QA teams and things like that. And those same things, we have a job dedicated for this build. In this job, we just have an Xcode call. We clean the target. So this time, we are using the target and not the schema. We don't define the SDK. We take the default one. The configuration is released. And we will set the marketing and technical version. The plugin support to have some variables using the token macro plugin, if I remember well its name. And those we can use, for example, the build number to set up the marketing or the technical version. It is more often just in the technical version that we need it to have something that will be updated each time we build the application. And this is necessary because on the Appaloosa store, we need to have a different version each time we publish a binary to let him recognize that there is a change and that it needs to deploy it on all devices. So we are using this ability to update in the build system the technical version. We build an IPA. We define which profile we want to use. It is one we created just for today with a wildcard for those who want to play with it. And that's all. My keychain, it is the default keychain in that case. But in a CI environment, you will probably have a specific keychain defined for that. And at the end, we upload to Appaloosa. Don't need to save. I launch. Go. Yes. So I launch it. So it will rebuild the application, but this time it will package it. It is what we can see. It created the package, and now it is uploading it on Appaloosa. And if everything is working fine, we have one Appaloosa developer in the room. So if it doesn't work, I kill him. No, it's working. So I have the notification on my device that a new version of this application is available and I can update it and just test and play with it. For both cases, it could be either used ourselves, we are using it for QA to validate our application, but you may use it also for a deployment in-house in your company to deploy an application. So this is what we did. Working, not working, okay, it's good. So we have 30 minutes. So are there some people who want to practice to play with this infrastructure and to set up an environment, a build system? We won't let you set up Jenkins. As I said, it's easy to do. But more to play, to create a job in Jenkins, to create your own app, to fork it and to create it and to deploy it on your device. So are there some people interesting to follow the hands-on or not? Yes, this is a problem. Xcode have to be installed because it's taking few gigabytes. Those, if you don't have it, it's difficult.
We have Xcode in on this Mac. So you, if you don't modify the code, you can build.
We can. If you just have the Git to clone the project and to publish it in GitHub, and just VI to edit the file, I think it's enough. You don't have to play with the simulator or the Xcode environment. Those, okay. Those, what we prepare is that we Matthew developed an application, a little application. Those we started on GitHub. You can fork it on your own account. And you can grab it then locally. You can clone the application. And we will show you, then you can, I will give you my access to my server to set up a build for those who want to do it on this application. Just need to give you my IP. It is the same. Okay. For those who want to log on my Jenkins server, you can go on the IP 10.150.15.198 two times on the 8080 HTTP port, I think, yes, 8080. So you can go. Just do the same. It will be easier. You can go here and you can break everything. And you can, you have admin rights. There is no security activity. Thus, you can create a job based on this application. Thus, if you need the IP, you tell me. I can give you it back. Those to set up the job, you have few things to do. The Git part. There is nothing special if you already know Git. It might work with SVN or others. It was just easier for us to use GitHub, but you might store your code everywhere, like always in Jenkins. We set up the Clang scan build. Thus, we have just one parameter to say it is the target to use. And we set up the integration job with what I said previously, the schema, the SDK, the configuration set to debug, and the argument, the additional argument. The ability to test. And at the end, you just have to activate the scan build result and the publish reports. Do I have to wait someone or no? Is there someone to wait or no? No, I continue. Okay. Those, if you take the project on GitHub, you will see that when you run the build, you will see that there is a test failure. It is almost unreadable here, in fact, sadly. In this test, which is in this file, we just have here, no, didn't click. You have just here a fail call to fail the test. So you just have to comment it or to write the test if you really want. But you just take the test, you edit the file, and you comment the error. You push it on GitHub, and you can restore your build and fix the build. If you want to play also with our demo, you will have to change your bundle ID because each application, it is the same on Android, and we have the same issue here on iOS. Each application has its own ID identifier. It is a bundle ID in this case, and it will be used by the store. It could be the Apple Store, but in our case, it is the Appaloosa Store to identify each application. So, if you want to publish several applications in parallel, you will have to set up a different bundle ID for each demo.
For the bundle ID, today we can compile an application with bundle ID that start with com.jenkins.jug.paris.app.something. So put just your name and it will build.
And thus you create a second job. This job is for the deployment, and as we said previously, same thing. You have the target to define the config of type release. You set up some versions. And thus you have just to take care to increase the version each time of the technical version. You build the IPA and you set up the embedded profile, which is in GitHub.
If you send me your UDID, I generate a store for today, which this QR code sent to, and you can download the store on your phone to download the app and push when Arnaud build an app.
So you may just take the URL you see it or the QR code on your phone. That's why we gave you the slides link to quickly have it. And thus you will download an application which is the private store dedicated for your deployment. And then you can log on it with credentials used by Mathieu. mha+jug@octo.com, Jenkins as password. And thus with that, you are able to download this application, which is at the end used only to manage notifications. Thus you can have the free version of Appaloosa, which is, we are attacked by Hungry Birds. We can have this application just to receive notifications from the store. It is easier to manage. Otherwise, we can use the web application of the Appaloosa store and we can browse versions, see if there is an update and things like that. The only interest of the store, the native application store, is to manage notification for your application to have updates. Appaloosa, always the same thing, we told it, just a token that you have access in the admin part of Appaloosa when you have a store, and a file name pattern. And thus with that, if you did all steps, you will receive a little application with all the agenda of today on your iPhone, and with all information about sessions. That's all. Feel free if you have some questions or if you want that we help you to set up your environment, if you have questions about our experience and feedback on this usage, which is new for us too. Myself, I started that 1 year ago to make continuous integration and deployment for mobile stuff. I did it a little bit for Android previously. We had few stuff because it was Maven-based, and thus we have a few things already automated. But for iOS, it is something that was really new for us. And I think that the new Xcode plugin that we added a few months ago, and some services like Appaloosa, but there are other stores available to nowadays, as a SaaS service or others, we can have really a good development experience, even for mobile developments, and not some things like we know with an in-house development make on a computer that maybe done a little bit as he want, as the developer want, and not following your company rules and standards and things like that. So we may really improve our clarity and our ability to create application, web mobile application. Thank you. If you have questions, we are early on the timing, just don't hesitate.